Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening to all Dinarians on the go and in the know, wherever you may be. It is November 9th, 2019. Know that today, we are one day closer to our goal than yesterday, and we all cross the finish line together. First article of interest. The Iraqi government announces that it will acquiesce if the parliament decides. 8 November 2019, 12 hours 28 minutes and 35 seconds, Baghdad. Iraqi government spokesman Saad al-Hadithi said on Friday that the government would resign if the Iraqi parliament votes. Speaking to Sky News, al-Hadithi said he accepted the parliament's decisions on the government, even if the government's resignation would resign. He added that the resignation of the government will turn it into a caretaker government, which represents an obstacle to the implementation of the demands of the demonstrators. Next article of interest. Al-Hadithi: the government has moved corruption cases against senior officials. 8 November 2019, 2010, Baghdad. Government spokesman Saad al-Hadithi said on Friday that the government has moved several cases of corruption against a number of senior officials. Al-Hadithi said in a press statement that the government is working to enact many reform laws in the country. He said the government was working on a new election law and a fair distribution of wealth. Is over. Next article of interest. Shelling with 15 Katyusha rockets targeted a U.S. military base in Qayyara, south of Mosul. 9 November 2019 by Ali Amirak News, Baghdad, agencies. 15 rockets landed near a U.S. military base in Qayyara, south of Mosul, on Friday evening, an Iraqi military statement said. The statement said that the rockets, which landed near the base of Qayyara, did not cause any injuries or material damage. The statement and the source did not say who was responsible for the attack, nor did anyone claim responsibility for the rocket fire. One Iraqi soldier was killed and another wounded when two mortar rounds landed in the Green Zone last month near the U.S. Embassy. Next article of interest. Al-Hadithi: the government will present a bill against corruption within days. 8 November 2019, 2111, Baghdad. Government spokesman Saad al-Hadithi said on Friday that the government will submit within the days of a bill against corruption. Al-Hadithi said in a press statement, "We accept the decisions taken by Parliament on the government, even if the decision to resign the government will resign," noting that the disruption of public facilities in Iraq is not in the interest of anyone. The draft law, if approved, will open the door to hold many officials accountable, al-Hadithi said. He continued that the government will submit within the days of a bill against corruption, noting that any new government will need time to implement the demands of the demonstrators. Next article of interest. Successful IBBC trade visit to KRI, 9 November, 2019. The Iraq-Britain Business Council, IBBC, took a significant group of members on a trade mission to KRI this week. Paramount was the need to review business opportunities and investment in the region and to learn directly from the Prime Minister Barzani his plans for business and industry. The group, led by Baroness Nicholson, UK Trade Envoy to Iraq, Christoph Michels, MD of IBBC, and Ang Razmi Al-Jabri, Deputy Chairman of IBBC, included representatives from Jaguar Land Rover, Crescent Petroleum, A. Siemens, Sardar Trading Agency, Garda World, Sterling Education, KPMG, G4S, Oil Serv Kuwait, and from the DIT Mr. Ruand Askari, and James Thornton of UKFCO. The Prime Minister introduced a number of ministers for discussion with the group, including KRI Minister of Electricity Mr. Kamal Mohamed Saleh discussing project finance and other related matters. The DG of the CRISMWA Joint Crisis Coordination Center Mr. Hashan Mohamed discussed the clearance of IEDs and mines and the handling of the overall IDP and refugee crisis that G4S have been heavily engaged with. In conversation, Mr. Barzani stated that the KRI government will bring in reforms to cut down on red tape for the private sector to develop. It will pursue a policy of registering companies through a one-window online portal which should allow company registrations to be done in the same time it takes in Western countries to do so. He also said that the new administration is streamlining overall bureaucracy for private businesses to limit unnecessary government interference. The government is also planning to draft a new bribery law to fight corruption and is looking at reviewing its financial framework to encourage throughout the economy, including education and health. Diversification of the economy is big on the agenda, with agriculture, tourism, and the manufacturing of goods being a priority. Qayyara should import less and produce more and eventually find markets outside its borders for its products. Foreign partners for all of this are sought after. A permanent revenue sharing agreement with Baghdad is top of the agenda, among other things, to allow credit export agencies to work directly in the KRIG. On Sunday, the planning minister and Mr. Amanj Rahim, cabinet secretary, Kurdistan regional government spoke, and the ministers for construction and electricity attended the British consulate reception taking place at the JLR showroom, kindly sponsored by Sardar Trading Agencies, thanks to Mr. Sardar Aldabani, chairman and CEO. Dr. Darlaka Ayat, chairman of KRI Federation of Chamber of Commerce and Industry in Erbil, hosted a Monday evening event, and on Tuesday the mission visited Crescent Petroleum offices. Next article of interest. Kurdish deputy: this is why the questioning of Abdul Mahdi was not included in the schedule of today's meeting. 9th November 2019, 1151 Baghdad. MP revealed the Kurdish bloc Shirwando Bardani, the reason not to include the paragraph of questioning Prime Minister Adel Abdul Mahdi in the agenda of the House of Representatives, on Saturday. Aldo Bardani said in a press statement that the discussion of the axes today within the session comes within the reforms demanded by the demonstrators. The council is still trying to meet their demands by voting on the necessary public interest reforms, he said. It is noteworthy that a number of political blocs within the parliament demanded the interrogation of Abdul Mahdi after the use of excessive force of demonstrators and the fall of dozens of martyrs and injuring thousands of them. Next article of interest. Iraq: put forward a comprehensive dialogue initiative with the participation of demonstrators and the United Nations. 9th November, 2019 Iraq. Speaker of the House of Representatives Mohammed Halbousi launched a national dialogue initiative with the participation of the United Nations and representatives of the demonstrators to formulate a comprehensive political project. Halbousi said in a statement received, Independent, a copy of it on Saturday, that Speaker of the House of Representatives Mohammed Halbousi received today Jeanine Blatchart, representative of the United Nations in Iraq. The statement added that Al-Halbousi reviewed during the meeting the latest political developments in the country and the legitimate demands of the demonstrators and the urgent measures taken to draw up a roadmap for the radical reforms of the political process in the country, including constitutional amendments and the directions of the interim committee formed by the House of Representatives, which decided to be a permanent meeting in expansion. Its work invites constitutional law experts in all segments of Iraqi society and representatives of the demonstrators to participate in the amendments. He explained that the President of the Council of Representatives discussed with the representative of the Secretary General of the United Nations initiative of the Comprehensive National Dialogue, which will participate all presidencies and leaders of political blocs and the spectrum of Iraqi society, judges, unions and trade unions and representatives of the demonstrators with the participation of the United Nations and representatives of countries accredited in Iraq, in order to formulate a present and a better future and a decent life for the Iraqi people. The statement pointed out that Al-Halbousi had expressed the readiness of the United Nations to provide assistance at all levels to achieve the objectives of this dialogue and to be a guarantor of its results and stand at the same distance from all to achieve the aspirations of the Iraqi people and maintain the stability, security and national unity of Iraq, stressing the need to ensure freedom of expression within the framework of democratic practices and the rule of law, the prevention of all forms of violations and the protection of public and private property. Next article of interest. Source: the nomination of the judge, Fakhzaddin, as a replacement for Adel Abdul Mahdi. 9th November, 2019 Baghdad. said more than one source familiar with the details of the political movement in Baghdad, said the high judge Zidane could be a compromise candidate convincingly to head an interim government substitute for ABDUL-ZAHRA, who accuses the government of failing to rear over the past year and the suppression of the demonstration's peaceful excessive force. The sources, who spoke on condition of anonymity and political and functional addresses, said that Judge Fake Zidane is highly acceptable to more than one political party influential in the process of forming any coming interim government, which can help to find a way out of the Iraqi crisis through the formation of an interim government. It undertakes fundamental reforms that satisfy the angry Iraqi street. A source revealed that the decision to replace ABDUL-ZAHRA and submit the resignation of his government is taken by the blocs of Syrian and Fatah as the largest in parliament, but pending the search for an alternative is acceptable and can be passed in the House of Representatives. Another source from outside Baghdad said that the name of Judge Fake Zidane is widely circulated as an alternative candidate to form an interim government, especially as he enjoys balanced relations with most of the influential figures in Baghdad. Another source confirmed the same information, that Judge Fake Zidane has a distinguished relationship and great support by the President of the House of Representatives, which is in constant communication with the President of the Republic and a number of members and heads of political blocs, which drives those blocs and personalities to search for the appropriate time and opportunity for put forward the idea of taking over the task of forming an interim government. The media center of the Supreme Judicial Council has denied the existence of an ongoing visit of the President of the Council, Judge Fake Zidane, to Iran or elsewhere. Next article of interest. From Iraq to Lebanon and Syria.The threat is one and the same. As U.S. President Donald Trump congratulates himself on the achievement of withdrawing from Syria, with the exception of the oil-producing area, Western capitals seem to be in a hurry to calm the situation in Iraq, Lebanon and Yemen. Everybody wants to facilitate forming new governments and contain tension, while no one seems to care about anything other than replacing one government with another, regardless of what the region is going through. Yet, since the outbreak of the current Lebanese uprising against the ruling elite and corruption 3 weeks ago, which led to the resignation of Saad Hariri's cabinet, the Secretary General of Hezbollah made three appearances in which he resorted to advice, directives, accusations and threats. Iraq is also going through a similar popular uprising calling for the resignation of the government and parliament. This uprising is sweeping the Shiite areas of central and southern Iraq, and has witnessed tearing down pictures of Iran's Supreme Guide Ali Khamenei and the Revolutionary Guards Al-Quds Brigade Commander General Qasim Soleimani. Incidentally, Soleimani had left Lebanon a few days before to Iraq, where he has been busy planning the containment and crushing of both uprisings. In both cases, fingers have been pointing to the Iranian leadership, which is obvious, since it would be absurd to separate the terrible living conditions in countries like Iraq and Lebanon from their virtual occupation and rule by Iranian-controlled militias. In Lebanon, Hezbollah's occupation has been the direct cause of the country's brain drain, lack of investment, concealment of widespread corruption, and destruction of its services sector. Likewise, in Iraq, the de facto occupation of the Popular Mobilization Forces, PMF, and its constituent militias have been sucking dry the oil-rich country's great wealth, including causing the closure of no less than 52,000 factories as Iran imposes its stranglehold on the Iraqi economy. Two valuable contributions to the subject were recently published in the U.S., covering Iraq, Lebanon and Syria. The first was an article by Samir Soumaidi, a former Iraqi interior minister and former ambassador to the UN in Washington, published by the Atlantic Council, and the second was a report on the growing threat to the Druze, published by the Middle East Institute, with collaboration of Etana Syria. Soumaidi wrote, "In Washington, some believe that despite the protests in Iraq that began in early October and continue apace, the current Iraqi government should be supported and given help as it responds to the just demands of the protesters. The reasons given range from, what is the alternative? The devil you know is better than the devil you don't. 2. This is the constitutionally elected government, and challenging it risks chaos. That analysis, he added, might be convenient, but it is wrong. It does not take into account what has led to this explosion of public anger. The May 2018 elections were all but boycotted by the electorate. The turnout was claimed to be around 44%, but many believe it was much lower. That contrasts with the 60% turnout in recent previous elections, even without all provinces fully participating. Then, in June 2018, a suspicious fire destroyed half of the ballots from the 2018 election, and the results were adjusted by an electoral commission, EC, which should have been independent but was not. He then pointed out to the fact that the constitutionality of the current political system is open to challenge in other important respects, including 1. The Constitution forbids discrimination on the basis of race, religion, and sect, but the current political order is predicated on the Prime Minister being Shiite, the President Kurdish, and the Speaker of Parliament Sunni. 2. The Constitution explicitly bans militias. But there exist in Iraq heavily armed militias, and not just the Popular Mobilization Forces, also known as the PMF, with declared allegiance to Iran. 3. Most importantly, the ruling clique has diverted the country's revenue from oil, the country's primary source of income, into the pockets of the elite through an elaborate patronage scheme and corruption. Young people would not go into the streets unarmed and aware that they face live bullets from the militias if they were not desperate. In conclusion, he wrote that the Iraqi government, as it is constituted now and despite all past and present promises and claims to the contrary, does not have the political will or the capacity to deliver a good governance. One sincerely hopes that the suffering stops and strong will of the Iraqis and the Lebanese proves strong enough to defeat this collusion. More articles of interest to come. Don't forget to hit that like and the subscribe button and check out the Currency Exchange Planner. The link is in the description panel below. Make sure to tell them the Dinarian sent you so you get the extra pre-negotiated discount as my subscriber. I encourage you, knowledge is power. Stay informed and stay alert. Over and out for now, the Dinarian.